Since the beginning of time on our planet, tectonic plates have been slow dancing on Earth's uppermost mantle. Where they touch, Earth's brittle skin reveals the immense forces beneath, through towering mountains, sudden earthquakes, and vast canyons diverging. The most accessible example of such a divergent zone is the Great Rift Valley, which has impacted the topography from southern Turkey, through the Horn of Africa, all the way down to Mozambique. The system is especially pronounced in East Africa, where the parting of the Somali and Nubian plate has formed the Albertine Rift, full of rugged ridges and deep valleys. The deepest and largest of these valleys have eventually filled with Africa's abundant tropical rainfall and are now forming the African Great Lakes. Along the 3,000 kilometer long crescent, a series of seven major lakes have captured 25% of the world's freshwater, and the southernmost one, Lake Malawi, is home to some fascinating peculiarities, which we'll explore in this video. Before we get into the oddities, however, let's lay some groundwork and quickly go over the geographical key facts. Chapter 1. Lake Malawi in numbers. At 29,600 square kilometers, roughly the size of Belgium or the US state of Maryland, Lake Malawi, or Lake Nyasa as it's called on the eastern banks in Mozambique and Tanzania, ranks among the largest lakes in the world. The north to south span of over 560 kilometers follows the shape of the western arm of the East African Rift Valley, which sank the lake bed over 2,200 meters below the surrounding plateau. In this valley, Lake Malawi is reaching a depth of over 700 meters at the deepest section, securing it the rank of the 8th deepest lake of the planet, with the 4th largest volume of any freshwater lake. However, this level is just a snapshot in the hydrological history of the lake. In 2005, a team of researchers extracted a 380-meter deep continuous sediment sample from the lake bottom, which reveals the past 1.3 million years of uninterrupted hydrological history and gives a detailed timeline of volcanic eruptions, the climate, and changes to the lake's biodiversity. Mapping the readings reveals that the lake has undergone a total of 24 cycles from flood to drought in this period, with level swings of over 600 meters, changing the lake's characteristic from its status as a freshwater tank to a shallow, saline and alkaline body of water, and back again. Today, the surface level has found somewhat of an equilibrium, with the inflow of the lake's drainage basin, which lies in a narrow band around the lake, sufficing to balance the very high evaporation rate. The remaining water of this balance is drained through Lake Malawi's only outflow, through the Shire River in the south, carrying the water along the Rift Valley until it confluences with the majestic Zambezi River. Heading back to the lake, it's finally time to look at the curiosities contained in and around these waters, bringing us to Chapter 2. Peculiarities of Lake Malawi. Being placed in the middle of a massive graben, Lake Malawi is surrounded by uplifted rift shoulders, and as such quite secluded from many external influences. In the study of evolutionary biology, such environments often act similar to remote islands, and the adaptive radiation creates an abundance of variants in species from a common ancestor. Where the Galapagos Islands have the finch, which were famously studied by Charles Darwin and served as the foundation for the theory of evolution, Lake Malawi has the cichlids. This family of small colorful fish has rapidly evolved along the shores of Lake Malawi, with hundreds of closely related but distinct species sharing the lagoons and rocky shores. Due to their distinct chromatic features with shimmering scales, they're the most popular ornamental aquarium fish today. From the 2000 species of cichlids which have been described globally, mainly around the tropics of the Americas, Africa, India, and the Middle East, 800 of these are found in Lake Malawi alone, making it a true wild aquarium and the most species-rich lake in the world. For the local communities, these fish are the backbone of their nutritional balance, presenting 40% of the people's protein intake. An exploding population around the lake and the resulting overfishing has put a massive strain on the fish population in recent decades though, but a partnership of NGOs and local authorities are actively pushing a transition from fishing to fish farming, which will alleviate this strain on the natural habitats. Cichlids are not the only source of animal protein around the lake, however. There's another species which thrives in the unique conditions of the lake and forms an integral part of the locals' diet. When environmental conditions align, clouds the size of skyscrapers are rising from the center of the lake and perform a dance lasting just a few days. These clouds are not a weather phenomenon though, but instead the adult form of the Chaoboros edulis, which transforms from its glassworm state into the lake fly in the hundreds of billions. Whenever the population erupts and the black clouds rise in the distance, the lake residents pull out their nets and harvest these midges to press them into burger patties or protein bars known as kunga cakes. While providing a delicacy to the people living on the lakeshore, the larvae state also plays an important role for the nutrient cycle within the lake, extending the habitable zone to layers way deeper than would otherwise be possible. As a result of steady temperatures and very little in and outflow of the lake, Lake Malawi is classified as a meromictic lake, which means that its water layers experience little to no mixing. As a consequence of this, organic matter and nutrients are often trapped in the brighter upper layers of the lake, but this is where the glassworm comes in. To evade predators in daylight, hundreds of billions of glassworms migrate from the light to the dark columns at dawn, down to depths of around 200 meters. Their daily migration creates a natural pump of nutrients to otherwise deep and dark layers, which then allows larger fauna that feed on these larvae to extend way deeper into the lake strata. While life in the lake runs like a well-greased machine in predictable cycles, the same cannot be said for the political situation of the nations surrounding the shore. For decades now, the situation around Lake Malawi has been tense, bringing us to Chapter 3, the political geography around Lake Malawi. Zooming in on the northern half of the lake on Google Maps, two dashed lines are separating the countries of Malawi and Tanzania. You can recognize this form of demarcation from places like the Kashmir region or Kosovo, and it means that there are some long-lasting border disagreements here. In the case of Lake Malawi, the convoluted colonial past of the British, Portuguese, and German occupiers in the region is leaving the borders of the lake in a stalemate. While the Portuguese in Mozambique left with a 1954 agreement in place, which splits the lake in half to the satisfaction of both countries, the northern section between the British and German colonial remnants is more contentious. In 1890, the Heligoland Treaty allocated the entirety of this lake section to Nyasaland, the precursor of today's Malawi. With the release of the colonial possessions in 1961 and 1964, however, disagreements quickly arose between the two new nations, where Malawi is referring to this treaty, whereas Tanzania prefers the more modern approach to the demarcation of country borders. Since the 20th century, the territorial demarcation between neighboring states across bodies of water has been done through the principle of equidistance. This principle is mostly created for delimitating territorial waters across seas and channels, but was quickly adopted to rivers and lakes as well. This has since been the foundation for Tanzania's counterclaim, instead of following the century-old treaty that has been drafted by their oppressors. With the formulation of the Law of the Sea by the United Nations in 1982, Tanzania's position only got stronger, yet Malawi continues to fish and license fossil fuel exploration in the disputed zone. While no armed conflict arose so far, talks have been dragging on for decades, and a misinformation campaign by Tanzania with a fabricated press release claiming that Malawi has accepted the Convention of the Law of the Sea has further fueled the situation in June of 2025. So far, there is no end to the disagreement in sight, and looking back at the immense population relying on stability in the region and the resources of the lake, we can just hope a sustainable and fair solution will be found soon. Overall, Lake Malawi is a phenomenon of true extremes. Built within one of Mother Nature's most ambitious projects currently reshaping the planet, it fosters an incredible biodiversity and should be guarded as a natural treasure trove. If you want to learn more about the most fascinating lakes in the world, I can recommend this video about Lake Baikal, the deepest lake in the world, nestled in another rift valley in the depths of Siberia. Or watch what YouTube thinks is best for you here. See you in the next one. Cheers.